positively charged particles called protons was discovered by the scientist Ernst Rutherford. I'm talking about atomic nucleus constituting of one proton and one neutron. The word proton actually means first. Neutrally charged particles called neutrons. Hello students, this is SD sir again from the Temple of Excellence, Vidyashram, Pre-University, Mysore. Today, I have a very beautiful chapter in store for y'all. Thrilling concepts. Actually, what modern physics is based on is well defined in the concepts of this chapter. So, I will be discussing the chapter nuclei in the coming sessions. Dear students, if you can recall when we did our atoms, I told my focus was completely to study the nature of electrons, right from the comprising of an hydrogen spectrum to the existence of spectral lines. We studied the behavior of the electron. Here, we are completely trying to understand the nature, the behavior, and the comprisement of a nuclei. So, my complete discussion will be on nuclei. For example, the general characteristics of a nucleus. We will study a very important topic called nuclear forces, mass defect, specific energy per nucleon. We will study the characteristics of nuclear reactions and end up with a very important event called as radioactivity. Before I can gulp into these topics, my today's session will completely involve understanding the basics. So, today we will have an introduction to the chapter called nuclei. Now, when it came to Rutherford's atom model, with the discovery of the nucleus through the alpha scattering experiment, we told an atom is spherical in shape. At the center, there is a positively charged nucleus and the entire mass of the atom, very important, is concentrated in this nucleus. Rutherford says the entire mass of the atom is concentrated at its center called nucleus, he puts a step forward and says, nucleus is small but a highly dense region. When I explain the characteristics of the nucleus, I will calculate the density of the nucleus. Just know the density of the nucleus is 10 power 13 times the density of water. Just imagine, nucleus is 10 power 13 times dense when compared to the density of water. So the conclusion of the Giger-Marsden experiment, or the so-called the alpha scattering experiment, was at the center of the atom, there is a very small region, but highly dense region, small but highly dense, where the entire mass of the atom is concentrated. So if I am figuring out the nature of the nucleus, the first point I say is, it is positively charged. It is placed at the center of the atom, and it is highly dense. So these are the features of the nucleus. Now, coming to the particles which comprise the nucleus, particles which constitute the nucleus, we know nucleus is made of protons and neutrons. These are the two particles which actually build a nucleus, protons and neutrons. Therefore, we say a nucleus comprises of positively charged particles called protons and neutrally charged particles called neutrons. These protons are positively charged, neutrons are neutral in charge, they don't carry any charge. Most of you wouldn't have known what actually is a proton. If you observe, which is the first element of the periodic table? Sir, it's hydrogen. Good. Why? Because it has a single proton and a single electron. And the word proton in Greek actually means first element, hydrogen, constituting of one proton and one neutron. The word proton actually means first. Therefore, we say nucleus has positively charged protons and neutral in charge, neutrons. Protons carry positive charge and neutrons are neutral in charge. Now we know the atomic nucleus was discovered by the scientist Ernst Rutherford. I am talking about atomic nucleus. It was actually discovered by the scientist Ernst Rutherford in the year 1919. And James Chadwick was the scientist who discovered neutron in 1932. Existence of neutrons, neutrally charged particle, was done by this scientist James Chadwick in the year 1932. So atomic nucleus was discovered by Rutherford in 1919, and neutrons were discovered by Chadwick in the year 1932. Now coming to the representation of the nucleus of an atom. Now, we represent the nucleus of an atom using the symbol X, A, Z. The nucleus of any atom is represented through the symbol X, A, Z, where X represents that particular element, uranium, radium, polonium, some element, particular element, and A is called as the mass number. So A denotes the mass number, which is actually the total number of nucleons in the nucleus. Mass number andre total number of nucleons present in that nucleus. Now what is this nucleons? It is the sum of protons and neutrons present in the nucleus. Mass number means the sum of protons and neutrons in the nucleus. So A is the mass number. What is mass number denoting? The total number of nucleons in a nucleus. And nucleons are nothing but protons plus neutrons. And very importantly, Z denotes the atomic number of the nucleus. Now, what is this atomic number? My dear students, atomic number is also called charge number of the nucleus. Alle helutinudi, charge number, number of charged particles, that is protons, inside the nucleus. So Z is the atomic number, which is nothing but the charge number, which gives the total number of charged particles inside the nucleus. And this A minus Z is denoted by N, which is the total number of neutrons inside the nucleus. One mark kelter hai. Given uranium 235, 92, how many neutrons are present in it? So the number of neutrons will be 235 minus 92. So this is how generally we represent a nucleus. Throughout this chapter, I will be using this representation. X, A, Z, where A is the mass number, it denotes the total number of nucleons, protons plus neutrons in the nucleus. Z, atomic number or charge number, the number of charged particles in the nucleus, which is the number of protons, and the difference of A minus Z is called the number of neutrons present in the nucleus. Now going to these definitions, very important students. ಪರೀಕ್ಷೆನಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ಗಳನ್ನ ಒನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್, ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ವಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಆನ್ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್. ವಿ ಸೇ, ಗಮನಿಸಿ ಕ್ಲೀನಾಗಿ, nuclei having same atomic number, the nuclei which has same atomic number but different mass number is called as an isotope. There should be two nuclei, they should have the same atomic number but their mass number should vary, then such nuclei are called isotopes. For example, H11 and H12. H11 is a proton, H12 is deuterium. ಈ ಡ್ಯೂಟೀರಿಯಂ ನ ಹೆವಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಅಂತಲೂ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಲೇಟರ್ ಯು ಕಮ್ ಟು ನೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಕೂಲೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ದೇರ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್. ಬೋತ್ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂಟೀರಿಯಂ have the same atomic number but mass number varies, so they are called isotopes, nuclei with same atomic number but different mass numbers. Isobars, nuclei having the same mass number but different atomic number, the other way of isotopes. Here the nuclei should have the same mass number but their atomic number varies. Observe madi, ferrous iron, nickel, ಎರಡ್ರದು ಮಾಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಇದೆ. ಐಎನ್ ಗುನು 58 ಇದೆ, ನಿಕಲ್ ಗುನು 58 ಇದೆ, ಬಟ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಿಯರ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ನಂಬರ್. ಐಎನ್ ಇಸ್ 26, ನಿಕಲ್ ಇಸ್ 27. So have the same mass number, different atomic number, constituting isobars. So isotopes, same atomic number, different mass number. Isobars, same mass number, different atomic number. Isotones, quite interesting. Nuclei having equal number of neutrons. They are nuclei which have equal number of neutrons but different atomic number. Ilodi H13 and He42. How will I calculate the number of neutrons? A minus Z. So 3 minus 1 is 2. 4 minus 2 is 2. The number of neutrons in both this nuclei is the same. But what about the atomic number? Varies. Such nuclei are called isotones. These are nuclei having the same neutron number but which is varying with atomic number, and they are called isotones. And finally, we study something called isomers. Nuclei having same atomic number, mass number, but internal structures vary. I don't talk too much about this because slightly absurd. These are the nuclei which have the same atomic number, same mass number, but different internal structures depending upon the nature of nuclear reactions they undergo. What type of reactions? Endothermic, exothermic, what is their quality resonance? Depending upon such terms, internal structure and energy states vary. But still they have same atomic number and mass number. Such elements are called isomers. When I take up nuclear reactions with examples there, more we speak about isomers. So, in my today's session, students, we have understood the basics of a nuclei. It is very dense, positively charged nucleus, the existence of protons and neutrons, representation, and some basics. My next session, I'll start with the characteristics of a nuclei. Until then, have a fine time. Thank you.